Well, hello and a very warm welcome. We are here in the Wangjiang Campus Gymnasium at the Sichuan University, and it is Taekwondo time. And we're about to get underway with four fantastic finals. Very, very useful fighters. Panipak Wompatanaket against Merva Dinchel. The elite are gathered here in Chengdu, and they certainly know what to do. So here we go, Panipak Wompatanaket in blue, Merva Dinchel in red. They know each other oh so well. The Olympic champion, the Thai fighter, has won the University Games twice already in that illustrious career. But she took a silver medal in the World Championships, and she lost to, well, you guessed it, Merva Dinchel. Turkey's top talent against Thailand's top fighter. A clash of legs in the centre. As Ying Jin Lee, the centre referee, keeps an eye on things. Team Thailand delighted. First score on the board. In terms of taekwondo, if you cut to the body, you get 2 points just like that. You get sensors on the socks and sensors on the head. If you hit the head, you get 3 points. And it will be the fine margins as we go into the last 2.3 seconds. Clock ticks down. Any scores on the board. Excellent stuff there. Oh, so unfortunate. Panipak Wompatanaket takes that round. She took a kick to the body. Merva Dinchel landed the head kick, but it was after the buzzer. So there's the hook to the body that scored for the fighter in blue. This one to the face was as clean as you like, but it was already past the time. So lucky for Panipak. But Panipak takes that first round. Panipak staying active, landing an excellent head kick there. The push come chop, and it's all come at the right time for Thailand. Half a minute, or halfway through the last minute now. Of course, Team Turkey have no video review card left. Panipak Wompatanaket 5 points up. This is a repeat of the World Championship final. Dinchel in red took the gold. At the moment, Panipak Wompatanaket turning the tables. Turning on the style down the stretch. Last 20 seconds. Dinchel doesn't want to settle for silver. She flicks one up to the face. Oh, so close. That's been the tail of the tape for the Thai. 10 seconds now. Panipak Wompatanaket. And she's once, twice, three times a champion here for FISU at the World University Games in Chengdu. She makes history. And she makes the top of the podium yet again. Incredible performance, richly deserved. And sportingly acknowledged there from Merva Dinchel. Ali Sahin likewise. Oh, what a match, what a moment, and what a win for Panipak Wompatanaket. Congratulations to Superada Kiskalt of Germany with bronze. Lu Miao Wei likewise for China. Merva Dinchel from Turkey with the silver. And it's Panipak Wompatanaket of Thailand, the Thai treble, now three times World University Games champion. Time now for the men's under 58 kilogram final between Uzbekistan and Iran. Amirbek Turayev against Alireza Hajipur. Well, that's a battle of composure. I've talked about the kicking and the punching. It's also about blocking. You've got to cover. So you can just about see the Uzbek's arm guard there on his left arm. There's a head guard though he needs for that one. A belter from Alireza Hosseinpour, pouring on the style. And that's why they're so cagey. They have to concentrate all the way through. Good flick to the face. In this race for gold. Oh, to the closing stages now. Amir Bekturayev coming forward, the fighter in blue, letting his legs go. Good back leg turning kick there from Hossein-Pour. Back kick landing just a little bit low. Crowd liked it. Good shot, sharp kick in the inside. Ali Reza, Hossein-Pour pouring on the style. 5 seconds, 5 points. And the young man from the Amal University avoids the spin kick and goes back to his coach with a well-earned first round in his pocket. And Amir Bekturayev will live to fight another day. Hube, the call from the Iranian coach, which means good. And it was certainly good viewing for the Islamic Republic of Iran. An engrossing semi-final for Turayev. He put himself into contention. And second round of the men's under 58 kilogram final. Still 0-0 on the scores. Can he find a way through? A little smile on the face there of the Uzbek, as if to say, okay, I've got a minute to go to try and get myself back into this. Not far away from the face. He might be facing up to a gamjum here. Which way does the referee see it? Did he fall or was he pushed? Well, there was a good little leg lock on the way through. Yep, good refereeing. Like that, good to see. Oh, there's a front leg to the face though. Worth a throw of the card. Well, the head guard sensors only scoring the part of the head guard. Obviously not, there's no electronic sensors on your face. Playing the card, have they played it right? The front leg to the face there. And just a little look in the face of Ali Reza Hossein-Pour. An acknowledgement to know that there was some contact. The Uzbek coach has asked for 2 kicks for 6 points, but certainly, yeah, 1 for 3. Yeah, that's absolutely fair. He's asking for 6 points. He's only getting 3. So you can only ask for 1 decision. So the coach just, not so much greedy, but hopeful to try and get the 6. But settles for 3. 4-1 to the good. Good front leg to the face there. Steps up and over. Scores nicely. Ali Reza Hossein-Pour. Can he get it done in 2 rounds? Goes for it again. The flexibility, incredible. Likewise, the evasive skills of Amir Bekturayev. Good little counter in the inside from the Uzbek. 2-point game, 10 seconds left. Key times it, one knock to the face there. And there's no video review card. And of course it hit the face, not the head guard. Landing clean, 6-4, the score's on the board. There's the headshot in response from Ali Reza. What a performance from Hossein-Pour. And the last seconds, the head kick from the Iranian. It's enough, he's done it. The World University Games champion. A win with a huge head kick. What a performance from this young man from Shomal University. What drama we had there. Lovely show of respect between the two men. Great performance, but graduating with gold. Ali Reza Hossein-Pour from Iran, Shomal University's finest. Park Chan from Korea with bronze. Bilal Kuskou for Turkey likewise. Amir Bekturayev with a super silver for Uzbekistan, but it's Ali Reza Hossein-Pour, the man from Iran, and he rules the roost here in Chengdu. So here we go, the women's under 67 kilogram final, Ikra Kayir of Turkey against China's Songji. Well, a brace of finals coming up with the host nation involved. The men's minus 80s to follow this. The Ikra Kayir will have to follow Songji. Good punch in the inside from the Turk, leaves a space though. Kong Fan Tao, the coach in the corner, happy with the work. Ali Sahin from Team Turkey, some concern. And that's a penalty, a gamjum given for stepping out. Even things up at 4-4. Krakaia from Kirkcal University. Studying the angles, good block from the tuck there. Did well to cover the head kick, covering herself well so far. Well, a huge atmosphere, a huge occasion, all the fours on the board. Landing with some force to the head, though, excellent head kick there. Ikrakaia silencing the home crowd for the moment. Songji though trying to fire forward and at least create a gamble. Good fitness from the Turk in blue, keeps it close. 4 point game in 30 seconds. Well, pressure is a privilege of the champions as another head kick lands, and this time the referee will have to count. Thankfully Ikrakaia is okay, took a big chop kick to the face there, but it was directly to the face, not to the head guard. So only the head guard has the sensors on it. So the referee, quite rightly, will ask for those 3 points to be added. This was the back leg right up and through the guard, right to the jaw, perfect. Ying Jin Lee, the referee, says there's three. Three-point game plus the Gamjon makes it a two-point game. Well, the Chengdus and the Chengdons don't look away because the front leg to the face there from the Turk makes it 11-all in the last seconds now. Ali Sahin, the Team Turkey coach, has his card in the air. He saw a front leg to the face. Yep, looking for 3 points for that. Songji trying to get a composure. Watch the blue leg there, right up to the head. First one, anything, oh, so close. Was it close enough? Well, Chungguk Jae-yo is trying to fight for it, go for it. And I'm sure back in Kirkcal University in Turkey, they're also shouting, very similar, unsuccessful, the card gone. It did look as if it flicked over the top of the head. All the 11s. Songji tries the back leg turning kick. It could come down to who has hit the protector more. The Chinese fighter lands one on the inside. Will it be blue? Will it be red? Trying to battle forward. Which way? The referee will signal to Turkey. Excellent stuff there. So the aggression of Ikrakaya, just so that you can know what's going on. The points will score, but also sometimes if you hit with not enough power, but you still connect, you'll get a thing called a registration. And that registration was enough to subdue the host nation. Every kick counts and every second counts now as Kong Fan Tao gives Songji a bit of motivation. A minute and some change now. No change in the score. Just as I say it though, Songji lands one short. Ikrakaya in blue, she has one round on the board. Can she get it done in regulation time? She could do with another big head kick. It's soaking in air from the rafters. I mentioned the importance of fitness. Can she summon up energy in the last 40? Or can Songji force a deciding third round? Right, you see the big breath in there from the fighter in blue. To deal with jet lag, hot conditions, and the heat of the battle here at the moment favouring Songji. The Turkish temerity leaves a space, and Ikrakaya makes it four on the board, 10 to go. There's the front leg counter. I wonder if the coach will play the video review card. They certainly will. Well, a front leg counter. The front leg, of course, the leg closest. Let's have a look at it. Any contact? Oh, you never know from that angle. There we go. Well, that was the previous one. X it is. Well, we're looking over the shoulder to try and see. So both cards gone. Is it going to be one round all? Looks like it. Ikra Khair nods. And Team Songji here in Chengdu raising the roof. So here we go, into the third and decisive final round. Ikra Khair of Turkey and Songji tied up at one round each. A pivotal scorer. It could come down to connections. Who's kicked the protector? Even if you don't score, you have to stay busy. Look at the breath in there from Ikra Khair, summing up all her strength, the young Turk. Songji hit the high notes early. Can't find a rhythm in this one. Well, you know what the crowd want. But it's what's the effort there of Ikra Khair. Hits the shoulder. Can she hit the heights on the way through? One score would do. Any connection. Will it go to Turkey? Will it go to China? It's going to the wire here. A backlight turning kick will give one more registration for Team China. The clock ticks down. Which way is it going to go? Who's got the most scores on the board? It is Songji by the very merest of margins. The more you hit the protector, even if it doesn't score, it registers. And that registers as the champion here for Songji. Super scenes for Song, a super silver for Ikra Khair. But for China, it's their first gold here in the Taekwondo at Chengdu. Well, dreams do come true as Songji gives the fans plenty to cheer here. Khalida Harad from France with bronze, Sarah Chari from Belgium likewise. Ikra Khair from Turkey takes the silver medal. But Songji, well, she was on song for sure, hitting the high notes and the high kicks, is the champion here in Chengdu. The men's under 80 kilogram, the welterweight final. Kai Zhang against Saliev Shukarat. Zhang, the shorter of the two, trying to keep his distance, keeping his head back. Nice little push kick to the body, that scores. Good punch in the inside. And Shukrat Saliev is beginning to show a bit of his energy. The second punch does score. And that's a good sign for him. If you can shift in and punch in the first round, it means you've got your distance already. Good counter punch there from Zhang. Turning kick to the head, round the back, claimed it as well. Celebrations there from Zhang. He's fighting with charisma and personality. Gets a big kick to his own head there. And I think we're going to actually see a video review watching the front leg. This was the punch and then the kick over the head there. Yep, thumbs up. Good refereeing. Kai Zhang has been good value, confident. And he's recovered well from that excellent win in the semi-final. Good shot though from the Chinese fighter to the body. Three-point game leaves his face open though. And he's convinced of it this time. So we're watching the front leg up and over. There's a toe to the head, that will score. Unsuccessful. I thought there was a tiny touch there. Nothing separating them as we go the distance. Good movement there from Saliev. Slips around. Can he slip one more on the board? Zhang lands the head kick though. That's the way to finish out a round. Gives the crowd plenty to cheer about. The big three-pointer. The margin will be two because he stepped out. Is there enough time for Saliev to get one on the board? It's going to be another Gam John with a second to go. 1 second, 1 point. Critical times now. couldn't be much closer. You could separate them with a credit card, but cashing in there was this young man, Kai Zhang of the Southwest University. One round in favour of the man in blue. He's halfway to glory in Chengdu. But what can Shukrat Saliyev do? 1 point game and a minute to go. Well, good push there, just in time. Kai Zhang staying steady. Shukrat Saliyev tries the big backlight tourniquet, leaves a space though, it's filled nicely. Zhang with the bang. Can he bank a gold at the first time of asking? They're within touching distance. Within touching distance of the head though. Excellent from Saliyev. Gamjon given though for holding. And the 3 points invalidated. Four points of a difference. Backlight turner kick, boots off the protector. You could hear it in Beijing, doesn't score. 20 to go. And you'll be able to hear the fans cheering in Chengdu in Beijing if this continues as is. Kai Zhang does well to avoid. He'll take the Gamjon though. On they go. Front leg to the face, not too far away. Kicking after Kallio. To be fair, the referee was on the blind side of Saliyev, tries a head kick of his own, it lands. Will that be a Gamjon? Which way is it going to go? Good referee, and he lets it flow. 10 seconds left, tied up here. Kai Zhang may still be able to land. How many registrations? Will it be enough for the host nation? He lands the head kick. He's going to land the title as well. What a moment here. It's a magic moment for this man in blue. 2 point game, 2 seconds left. Defence, the watchword, the push kick will seal it. A big step up, a wonderful, magical moment in Chengdu. Dreams do come true. Well, he's not got the flag, but he flies the flag high for Team China. Southwest University will be delighted with that. Kai Zhang, imperious, impressive, and of course, ecstatic as well. Great moments. Magical moments. The champion from China is Kai Zhang. Mehran Bakhordadi of Iran with bronze. So Gongwoo of Korea likewise. Shukrat Saliyev with a super silver. But it is Zhang Kai who gave it a try and goes back with a gold. Congratulations, he is the champion. We'll be right back.